Good day, students. This is mathematics class for grade 10, chapter 1, real numbers. Exercise 1.4, page number 17 of your mathematics textbook. Question number 2. Write down the decimal expansions of those rational numbers in question 1 which have terminating decimal expansions. So in question number 1, I solved from question 1 to 6, isn't it? So out of that I found 1, 2 and 4 and then 6. All these numbers were terminating decimal expansions. So first one was 13 by 3125. So they have told write down the decimal expansions of those rational numbers which have terminating decimal expansion. So here first, second, fourth and sixth had terminating decimal expansions. So first one was 13 by 3125. Now let us write down the decimal expansion of this number. So here, if I divide 13 by 3125, this takes time, isn't it? To divide 13 by 3125. So another method is, we need to write 13 and the denominator is in terms of powers of 5, it is 5 to the power 5. And then you need to multiply with 2 to the power 5 and divide by 2 to the power 5. So next, what do we get? We get 13 into 2 to the power 5 is 32 by, this can be written as denominator, can be written as 5 into 2 to the power 5. Let us simplify this. We get 416 by 5 twos are 10, it is 10 to the power 5. So 10 to the power 5 can be written as with 5 zeros, isn't it, students? Yes. So the decimal form of this number, that is rational number, will be 0.00416. So this is how we need to find the decimal expansions of the rational numbers without doing the long division. Now next is the second one, which was 17 by 8. So 17 by 8 can be written as 17 by 2 to the power 3. So next, let us multiply 5 to the power 3 and divide by 5 to the power 3. Next, we get 17 into 5 to the power 3 is 125 by, here it will be 2 into 5 to the power 3, which will be equal to 17 into 125 by 10 to the power 3. So 17 into 125 gives 2125 by 10 to the power 3 is nothing but 1000. So this is equal to 2.125. Okay, next was the fourth one. Fourth one was 15 by 1600. So here I can write 15 by 1600 in terms of 2 to the powers of 2, I can write 2 to the power 6, isn't it? 2 to the power 6 into 5 to the power 2. So now let us multiply this with 5 to the power 4 and divide by 5 to the power 4. See here, so here this was 2 to the power 6 into 5 to the power 2. So I have to make this equal, that is, if it is 2 to the power 6, even this should be 5 to the power 6. So I need to add, that is, 5 to the power 4. 5 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 4 will be 5 to the power 6, isn't it? So I have to multiply and divide by 5 to the power 4, which will be equal to 15 into 5 to the power 4 will be 625. And now you see 2 into 5 to the power 6. So this will be equal to 15 into 625 gives 9375 divided by 10 to the power 6. So this will be equal to 9375 by how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this will be equal to 0.009375. Is this clear, students? Okay, now next, let us see the sixth one. Okay, so sixth one was 23 by 2 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 2. So here, this one, I can write it as 23 by, so here it is 2 to the power 3. This is 5 to the power 2, isn't it? So I have to multiply and divide with 5 to the power 1. So this 5 to the power 2 into 5 to the power 1 gives 5 to the power 3. So I get 2 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 3. So this will be equal to 23 into 5 by 2 into 5 to the power 3. So 23 into 5 gives 115 by 10 to the power 3. So this will be equal to 115 by 1000, which is equal to 0.115. Is this clear, students? Okay. Next, I've given you three homework problems, that is 8th, 9th and 10th. In question number 1. So you need to state whether those rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. And if the decimal expansions of those rational numbers have terminating decimal expansion, then you need to write the decimal expansions of those rational numbers which have terminating decimal expansion. Is this clear, students? Question number 3. The following real numbers have decimal expansions as given below. In each case, decide whether they are rational or not. If they are rational and of the form P by Q, what can you say about the prime factors of Q? So there are three cases here. First case is 43.12345678 9. So this is a terminating decimal expansion, isn't it? Yes. Now we can represent this in the form P by Q. What can you say about the prime factors of Q? Since it is a terminating decimal expansion, the prime factors of q, that is the denominator, is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m, isn't it? Yes, so let us write. So the prime factorization of q is of the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power m. Since this is a terminating decimal expansion, its denominator will have the powers of 2 and powers of 5. Okay, next, second case is 0.1201, 20001, 20001, 20000. So, this is an irrational number, isn't it, students? So, here it is non-terminating as well as it is non-repeating. So, it is an irrational number. It is an irrational number.